that, and let's look into the legal aspects of just what we know today. Go in any order you want, which is we have Joe Biden on tape. You're not getting the $1 billion. You're not going to get the $1 billion. You got to fire that prosecutor. You don't fire that no $1 billion. You got 6 hours. Son of a bee. They fired him.
You know, it's amazing how either clueless or obtuse or arrogant Joe Biden is to brag on camera more than once that he was extorting Ukraine to the tune of $100 billion in American taxpayer funds in what I think John's documents tomorrow will prove was an attempt to benefit his son. It is a crime to confer a benefit in exchange for something of value or to withhold and extort money for something of value that in this case would benefit his son. John's great reporting, not just the documents. He was the first to interview the fired prosecutor, Shokin. Shokin also has been consistent. He told the Washington Post, and I quoted in my column today on FoxNews.com, that, you know, they were closing in on Hunter Biden. And it wasn't, and Shokin says it was Joe Biden's extortion that caused his firing. And that's not just relevant, it may be dispositive of potential charges against Joe Biden. And this president, Donald Trump, has a constitutional duty to uphold the law, to enforce the law under the Take Care Clause, as I mentioned last night. Failure to do so is really sort of a breach of his duty. And it would be irresponsible. And so this is what the tape-recorded conversation said today. Did you hear President Trump make a demand, a quid pro quo,
no,
a condition, a promise? The answer to all of that is absolutely not. And yet Nancy Pelosi had the temerity to step in front of television cameras, admit, oh, gee, I haven't read the transcript of the conversation, but President Trump is dead bang guilty of something. We're going to impeach him.
All right. We got to leave it there. We're going to put all these documents tomorrow right on the screen so you can see them. John Solomon, Greg, great on the law. And also John did interview, along with ABC, The Washington Post, this fired prosecutor. And he was very clear. Yeah, he was told he was fired because Joe Biden demanded it. Or else he's going to take his $1 billion and go home. Here now is...